Happy New Year, my lovely ones, my lovelies. How are you all doing? I hope all of you celebrated the Christmas and New Year in a wonderful way, in a unique way. Nice to see you again, to see you in a beautiful year like this, year 2019. I'm so glad, I'm happy to see you again and to speak to you about the new year and about what God is doing and what is about to do. You can also see that I celebrated Christmas and New Year wonderfully. It's showing that I have a wonderful time with my family. I have what is called rest. I rested enough, I eat, I drank my normal red wine, the best of the best, as God is blessing us. So I'm so happy. So I know that you too, you celebrated it and you enjoyed it in a wonderful way. So, but I want to really talk to you. I want to talk to you concerning some things. I know some of you doesn't celebrate Christmas. What is wrong with you? Are you okay? You know, I have to talk about this. Some of you doesn't celebrate Christmas and they said it's a pagan something or whatever they call it. All right. Even if Christmas is for pagan something, pagan worshiping something as they trying to bring to us. I didn't want you to be ignorant of this. They call it to celebrate the birth of our Savior, Jesus Christ. I don't want to know. People, let me tell you something. Don't try to know too much. Don't know too much to fail in life. Don't know too much to fail in life. Even Solomon in his wisdom, overloaded wisdom, cost him damage. Over trying to know everything may cause you damage. Sometimes you take your eyes off something. You learn to take your eyes off some things. Because if our God is not taking his eyes off some things, there's no way he would have saved me and you. If you really want to see everything you are doing, If you truly want to look into everything you are doing, into your inner chamber, you see that there is nothing that will cause him to come to save me and you. So, my people, I want to just advise you, don't know too much. To fail in life, don't, my language for you for the new year, my message for you is, don't know too much to fail. Don't try to know too much, to know more than your maker. It causes you failure. You will fail in life. When you want to see everything, when you want to know everything, it will cost you damage. Don't know too much. Don't know too much to fail in life. As long as the only thing I see, the only celebration that I see every year, that the whole world stand in awe, is this Christmas. All of us celebrate our birthday. I celebrate my birthday. Everyone celebrates his birthday. Even if you don't celebrate, people say happy birthday, the day that you was born. Somebody who died also have the day that he was born. So if the people of the world decided to choose a day, they did not know the day that he was born. And nobody knows the day that he was born. Nobody knows. I don't know. And nobody knows the exact day that he was born. But the people of the world choose the end of the year to step into in a new year, to set aside, to celebrate his birth, the day that he was born. And for the whole world to give, you know, to exchange gifts. Because the birth of Christ, the birth of Christ, as we all hear, the three wise men presented a gift to him. God gave the highest gift in the person of his son, Jesus. So his birth was accompanied by great gift to the three wise men that visited him when he was born. So the whole world decided to set aside a date to celebrate his birth. Muslim people celebrate this. This is the only thing I travel around the world. I see that all over the world they celebrate Christmas. My Arab friends, they all send me Merry Christmas. I saw them putting on a cap, I don't know, doing it. Let me tell you something. It is an honor to our God. It is an honor that the whole world is celebrating the birth of Jesus Christ. Don't try to know whether there's any deceit or any selfish interest or any demonic thing that's behind it. As long as they called it to celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ, don't try to know too much. Use that day to let people know about Jesus. Use it to show love to the people. Don't try to know more than other people that you know that they are ahead of you. And don't try to know too much by saying people should not celebrate Christmas, because they are celebrating it and they're giving glory to God. So it's left for you if they are giving it to some people said it's a demon in mass that they're celebrating. I don't want to know more than what I know, that it is a day set aside to celebrate the birth of our Savior Jesus Christ. Period. This is how I take it. I celebrate it and I'll keep celebrating it. I call people, I give people gifts as I can. I celebrate Christmas and I'm happy with my family. So you have to celebrate Christmas because they said it is the day to celebrate the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ, the day that he was born. I believe he was born because I know that he died. So before one can die, one was born. He was born. So this is what I want to bring. And as much as they are saying it is to celebrate Jesus, come on, people, come on. You don't need to bring it into argument or into talk. If you don't want to celebrate it, just stay on your own. Stay aside. Allow other people to celebrate it. I use it to show love, to tell people about Jesus and to enjoy my life and to thank God for the whole year. So it is just like that. And this is what I want to tell you. Don't know too much to fail in life. So enjoy your life. This life, let we Christians stop bringing the world down. That's why the people of the world doesn't believe in us anymore. We keep bringing things down. When they are moving forward, they are going ahead and we are still going backward. Come on, stop that. It doesn't help. I advise you to take that your mentality. Keep it one side. Celebrate Christmas. It's important. Celebrate it. Okay. All right, so this is what I want to say. It is a great honor that they are celebrating the birth of the one that you are calling, the one you believe in, the one that you are calling your Savior. So if people of the world bring out that time, the Christians will say, let us bring time, bring a day to celebrate the birth of Christ, the birth of Jesus Christ. If people of the world bring it, so what are you talking about? If they like, they should use that day to do something they want to do. It is on their own head. They call it the celebration of the birth of Jesus. So use that day to show love, to give gift to one another, to rest for all the stress of the year. Relax, eat good food, chill with your family, go meet friends. You know, this is what life is all about. Remain blessed and for now begin to celebrate Christmas. Don't look too much to fail in life. Bye. My New Year message. Don't know too much to fail in life.